Much they have already spoken about the opportunities in aerospace. I'll be talking about opportunities as well as challenges. And my presentation I'll be covering basically in three parts. First is opportunities in terms of defense sector, why we are calling this opportunity, and also aviation sector. Then I'll be covering on challenges and support to overcome challenges, what can be done and what is available. And at the end, I will conclude. Air Marshal, they have already given you the brief of all this, what I've listed here, so I will not go into detail. The fact of the matter is that India is spending a lot of things in the import of the defense materials. And not so that is a need to create the self-reliance in defense sector. And government has done a lot of things recently to open up this sector. Again, M. Marshal Desai did the brief most of the things here. So again, I will not go into detail of this. But the fact is that success of Tejas and space program has increased the confidence in us that yes, we can do this, we can master this technology, and we can play a very important part, a role of ours in creating this complex and sophisticated system required for the defense and aerospace. The strategy to involve MSME for manufacturing after creating technology and a prototype, like DRDO does develop a technology, and that technology then transferred to the MSME and MSME through the TOT route, where MSME can take part and manufacture this particular item developed by the technology developed by the DRDO. And also, defense encompasses every sector. The way I say that which industry can take part in the defense. I would say the defense encompasses every sector. All of you can take part in defense in some way or other. Only thing that you need to have the vision and will to get into the defense aerospace sector. Aviation industry, when you talk about, here when I talk about aviation, is basically the civil aviation I'm talking about. Because when you talk about military aviation, gets into the defense part. So when I talk about opportunities, why we are calling opportunities in defense and I mean aerospace industries, then I'll try to quickly summarize in few slides. The aviation industry can be broken down in few parts, a few sectors, sub-sectors, like commercial aviation, general aviation, airport and infrastructure, again, very big requirement is there. Aviation manufacturing and MRO requirement, UAVs going, is coming in a very, very big way in the near future, and skill development. The industries, MSME, which are in a training site can get into the skill development, so that also is an opportunity, the way I look at it. What is the scenario in commercial aviation? There are 14 scheduled airlines in India operating, and they have only 508 aircraft, and most of these aircraft are basically from three companies, Boeing, Airbus and Bombardier. These three companies basically encompasses almost total fleet of civil aviation fleet of ours. But you'll be surprised to note that number of aircraft ordered by these airlines is 1200, which will be supplied to Indian industry in next 3 years and next 10 years. That means 500 aircraft, number of aircraft today operating in Indian skies will increase to about 1700, that is threefold thing. So that tells you the opportunities available in this. Number of aircraft by unscheduled companies, airlines like private jet and thing like that, it's about 112 with only 350 aircraft. Number of aircraft for order on this is actually not known. So if you add this I'm sure also is going to be multiplied by 2 or 3 or 4 fold, and that will also tell you the opportunity available in this. Increase in air traffic is about 20%. And the total CAGR on the next 10 years anticipates about 11.7. So that shows the growth of this. The freight, air freight CAGR is going to be around 7.2%. And Indian commercial aviation industry is poised to be the third largest in the world. Today we are about 7th or 8th, but in next 10 years going to be third largest in the world. When I talk about general aviation basically small aircraft. And normally 70% of the aviation business basically taken by this general aviation, but actually creates 30% of the revenue. This particular field, general aviation, very nascent in India. So this field also is going to be grow in a very, very big way. So here for general aviation, for smaller aircraft also can be taken as a very big opportunity for all of us. Airport infrastructure. Number of airport being modernized today, around 39 airport is being modernized by Airport Authority of India, and at the cost of about 13,000 crore. Again, there is an opportunity here. And 100 airport in next 10 years, that is what is planned. Udaan scheme, which all of us are aware of, which are basically interconnecting this small airfield in Tier 2, Tier 3 cities. Gujarat alone, there are 7 airports are being developed, and there are 17 airports are planned more, and 208 helipads are planned more. Now, all this will require equipment and manpower and all those things. So you can imagine the opportunity available there. Manufacturing and MRO. Airlines spend about 13 to 15% of revenue in MRO, that is maintenance repair. And 90% of MRO activities are done abroad. So if you even get into the MRO field, also is a very, very, very big opportunity. Same for manufacturing. Manufacturing was civil and military aircraft under Make in India, Tata Advance, Reliance, Mahindra, Adani, Indian Air. I mean, a lot of people have gone into this. Now, when I talk about manufacturing, I'm not trying to segregate military aviation and civil aviation. But all this thing actually provide you a lot of opportunity as a Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3 companies, or as an ancillary to all these companies. UAV. All of us, I'm sure you have seen UAV taking photograph in some even marriage and things like that. They are basically UAVs. UAV is going to come in a very, very big way. I'll give you an example. Like, for example, Russia is coming out, is working on a project with a fighter aircraft. And they are building the two versions. One is a manned fighter aircraft to be flown by a pilot, and second unmanned version, which are likely to come in operation by about 2040. So UAV, basically when unmanned airborne machine, when you talk about, that is the scope. Amazon and all trying to work out a delivery of item to your door with the UAV. The unmanned taxis in Dubai, and Google and Uber are working on that. So this particular thing is a very new sector and will require a lot of technology advancement, software, embedded technology and all. That is another one opportunity. And main civil use of this technology is going to be security and surveillance, like mapping, surveying, photography, load carrying or delivery. So again, this sector is very, very fascinating and give you a lot of manpower requirement. Now, when you do all this, there are always going to be manpower requirement. Like, for example, even scheduled civil airline, when you talk about today, about 62,000 are employed. The next 5 years is going to be increased to about 150,000. Now, one employee of civil airline, direct employee, actually gives employment of 10 more in indirectly to other sectors. So, you see the manpower requirement growth. And this manpower requirement growth in the operation itself is going to be so large for training and of this manpower is a very big opportunity available to us. Similarly, manufacturing and MR manpower. And then I'll say, as far as the opportunity is concerned, a lot needs to be done in the field, and therefore, good opportunity is available. So talk about these opportunities. But is it so easy, or is there any big challenges to get into defense and aerospace? So I would like you to not frighten you, but caution you with these challenges which is there in defense aerospace, because it is slightly different than a commercial business what you are doing here currently. So I'd like to slightly brief you on this. Now, first of all, first question will come into your mind, how do I enter into this sector? Because this also is unknown thing, newly opened sector. So I would like to first and foremost say that identify your strength based on what you have done. What are your strengths based on machinery, technology, what you are handling? And identify the technology in which you are, which you have interest. That is the first and foremost, I think, you must decide. And thereafter, you have various options to enter into this sector, which I will try to list it out. May not be comprehensive, but an indicative. What is the direct contact with Army, Air Force, Navy? We have Guru Captain Nanwal here. He is the boss of the indigenization from Indian Air Force. He is the center point of that. So like that, Army, Navy, DRDO, and all those places have. So be in touch with them, sites are available, and maintain a direct contact Make in India projects like M. Ashu Desai has briefed us, and I'm sure Brooker and Enval also will be speaking about it. There are Make in India projects for this, so you can get into this. As a vendor partner with weapon launching platform manufacturer, like for example, Adani has gone into this UAV project and Gripen aircraft project. And if the UAV project was already started in Mundra, setting up the facility. Gripen, if they get the contract, facility is going to come up in Gujarat. So, they will have tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 companies. Be in touch, see who is tier 1 company, can you supply to any one of this? That is another way. Civil aircraft and system manufacturer like Airbus, Boeing, and a lot of other companies are coming and setting up the facility. Again, you can be supplier to this company, or if you have the capability, you can be the direct supplier to this. Mr. Vipul is there, he is in touch. I'm sure he will be able to throw a lot of light on this. As I told you, DRDO, TOT is a defense and aerospace. You can buy TOT from them and create this, depending on the technology which you are interested in. Association with foreign companies, you can have now FDI is available. You can get, depending on your interest, you can get to direct the JV or association with foreign companies and start making India in India. So please be aware that the opportunity not only for items that go in the system, like for example, weapon system and proper aircraft, but there are also tools, testers, ground equipment, a lot of other things are required. Which I'll be talking about the challenges about quality and qualification requirement may not be that stringent in this thing. So maybe you can start with that depending on your capability and requirement. So it is not only the weapon launching platform we are talking about, but a lot of other associated systems which do not fly, are not airborne. There also a lot of things are required, like radar and other associated systems are there where you can get in. Now, what are the main challenges once you get in? First of all, volume. Like for example, one of the person I'm talking to many industries. One industry said, "We like my company run 24/7." It was from the process industry.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, I'll try to finish as soon as possible. Try to meet the time limit, sir. No, we cannot. Auto ancillary 5 lakh per car. Here is not going to be there. Gripen aircraft is manufactured with 10 to 12 aircraft per year. So volume is going to be a challenge. Input material, product, and power and process qualification. Because aircraft is airborne, like your car is unserviceable, you can park the car. Aircraft, you can't park the car. So there is a requirement of very stringent requirement of quality and process qualification requirement. Documentation, especially in civil aircraft, DGCA has got very stringent documentation requirement, which in a normal way you are not used to it. So that is another going to be challenge. It may appear that a lot of government control is there, but it is basically because to ensure that the safe and good quality things are. ROI, that's why normally we say, mera paisa kitna saal mein wapis aayega, 3 saal, 5 saal. No, here it will be a long-term vision you must have. So that again is a challenge, going to be a challenge for you. There will be requirement for you to invest in very heavily in R&D. Again, I'm sorry to say, but MSME normally not used to invest in R&D. So you have to R&D, you have to have a capability of innovation and ability to forecast the technology which you are in. Because even if you go buy the technology, the TOT from DRDO, you have to improve upon those products. Then you don't know the defense organization, like, okay, you know now Brooker and Enval, but how do I reach to the right people? So that again is a challenge which you have to face. Delay in RFI and RFP, after the prototype is approved, RFI, RFP is not issued within that time. So that is again going to be a challenge that Air Force and Army, they will have to work on that. Some time frame can be set, that once prototype is approved within 100 days, for example, RFI, RFP must be issued. So that has to be from both the sides. Finance, but I was very happy to hear yesterday's thing. There are three people. I'm sure finance problem of your answer is already answered in yesterday's thing. But to have a relook at veterans, like me and people who are there. I mean, we have a lot of capabilities and all for a skilled manpower and things like that. Today, you look at me only as a security officer or HRH chap or admin chap. No, we are technically very qualified and we can do that. So you can have a relook at veterans to help you out. Availability of trained manpower, again, going to be a challenge in this sector. So finally, the way I look at it, there's a need of change in overall attitude from the way normal commercial business is done. That's the first thing I think MSME will have to do to change in attitude of this. Way forward, need change in overall attitude, which I mentioned. And we are in the process of setting up an ecosystem like Health Engineering College and all. Siemens has set up 120 crore Care Camp Center. We are trying to convert that in a very classic way of center of excellence for defense and aerospace. Air Marshal Desai and his team, we are all involved in that. Air Force 15 BRD, that is Sukhoi overhauling agency, he's already, and one more BRD from Ahmedabad, is already associated with this. So live project, live problems will be given, which you can find a solution, you can get attached to that. CII, we are trying to set up in CII, some formal cell or thing like that, where you can be helped. Air Force Association, which is headed by Air Marshal Desai, where all of us are there, you can contact us for any help required. And maybe, I mean, concerned like me, you can hire our boys to do that. At the end, in conclusion, I would say there's a great opportunity in defense and sector because the change policy of the government gives the opportunity. Aviation sector is a fast growing, and I wouldn't mind making a statement that the last 15 years of Indian growth was driven by IT industries. Next 15 years of Indian growth is going to be driven by defense and aerospace industry. So do you want to miss the bus or you want to be part of the growth? That you'll have to decide. But these opportunities have their own challenges. MSME need to work on the challenges to take advantage of the opportunities. Yeah. Today in Gujarat, ecosystem is being created. I told you, we are trying to do it in LDS, CII, a lot of other things which we are discussing with Air Force and CII. I'm sure things will be able to put in place in the next 4 to 3 months. And we will, I mean, through CII, I think all of you will be informed accordingly. What I feel the MSME must take advantage of this opportunity for the growth and be part of the Indian growth. Feel free to contact CII, Air Force Association, or myself for any help. Thank you very much.
चालू जमाने निशान भी यूट्यूब पर मर से
करी जो
चालू सीआईए
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी मॉर्निंग मास्टर गुड मॉर्निंग